Billy, what's the latest at the Electoral Commission?
Yes, good morning to you, Romeo Busiku. Of course, this is the Electoral Commission headquarters, and we know that Article 78, subsection 1C, of course, gives powers to the electoral colleges to elect their workers' MPs that are supposed to represent this section of workers in the parliament. But we know that already we have five MPs representing the workers. Of course, these are Honorable Margaret Rabushaija, there is Honorable Dr. Sam Oriomoki, there is Honorable Charles Bakabulindi, there is Grace Kunihira, and of course, this today being Tuesday and Wednesday, we're going to be seeing the nominations of those who will be representing these members, these workers, this college in the 11th Parliament. But with me here is one of these who are the incumbent, Margaret Rabushaija. She has been here so early to make sure that she is one, she's nominated today. And she's going to let me know whether she has any concerns about these nominations and of course this sector or the workers whom you are representing. This has been a very tough year for your constituents. But first of all, good morning to you, Honorable Margaret Rabushaija.
Good morning, and I salute all of you viewers, NTV viewers. Okay. I'm Margaret Rabushaija. I represent the workers in the 10th Parliament, and I've served for my first term. I would wish to have another term. And the reason is that I've been there for the workers. I've been a voice of the workers, because the legislator is supposed to represent in Parliament, leave alone legislation. This year has been very difficult for us as workers. But is there anything that I've done? I want to say that I think those people who regularly watch the TV and sessions of Parliament can agree with me that I started with the medical workers and nurses. When the COVID situation started, I brought it on the floor of Parliament that these people, because they are the ones, particularly the nurses, who look after us in the hospital, they do a lot of work. They come to take your pressure, to measure, do you have diabetes? They come and bring the medicines. They are the ones who make the beds. And at times, if the patient is very weak, they are the ones even who washes, I would say, supports the patient in all forms. So because of that, I requested on the floor of Parliament, and it's on record, unanswered, that these people should not go home. They should remain in the hospitals, because they are bound to infect their loved ones at home. If they contracted COVID, then the people at home would suffer also. And the loved ones are the children, they are the spouses. And if it worked for me, if it worked for them and they remained at the place of work, I celebrate that at least that was my wish. And also,
okay. Before we even leave that, as you celebrate this, that is commendable, but notwithstanding, we know that many of these health workers, some of them have not been paid for like 3 months now. And when they see you as their voice, the workers in Parliament, they think that maybe you are not pushing their voice. They need to be getting something from their sweat.
We need to understand that a Parliament, we have not been in session almost for about 1.5 months. I had it only 2 days ago, and I think that's when it came out, the voice came out that they have not been paid. So it's very difficult to keep following every hospital, because I'm not on the health committee. But when I get to know, and I have an opportunity to go on the floor of Parliament, I will represent them, but we are not in session right now. So that one, I think someone can understand the situation. But if they have been able to even to get a representative with the president, because I also propose that one of them at least should represent their interest on the committee, national committee chaired by the president. And it worked. They got someone to represent them. To me, I did something. You remember that New Vision, when they started deleting people, I was informed, because I had attended the celebrations of the journalists. And they brought it to my attention that they were deleting, they were downsizing New Vision. I brought it on the floor of Parliament.
Also talk about you as a professional teacher. You were the chairperson at one time, the chairperson of Uganda National Teachers Union. But we know that now the teachers are out of school for 9 months. They are not getting anything. They would like to get something. But yes, there is a stimulus package that was given by the president, pronounced by the president, to bail out these teachers. But up to now, many are still starving. Even some have been chased out of their houses.
Yeah, my heart goes to those people in the private sector. Otherwise, those on government, they have been getting their salary and they have never missed. But those in the private sector, my heart goes to them because they have really suffered a lot. But when they have suffered a lot, the president promised that there was something that was going to give the 20 billion, and they have been following it. The PS told me that they are following, they are trying to find a global, national representation where this money can be sent, like they did to UNATU. Okay. When they sent us money, when they gave us money in 2011 for the SACCO, we started looking for other SACCOs in the different countries, the different parts of the country or district level. We got 96 and we brought them together. They are the ones who formed the Walimu SACCO, not UNATU, much as the money was given to UNATU.
Thank you so much.
So that's what I think we can do in that sector, and the government, the PS at least is following it up.
Thank you so much, Honorable Margaret Rau. She's a workers MP, and she's here at the Electoral Commission to seek nomination for being nominated again to contest for this slot that has five seats in the House of Parliament. But we know that today and tomorrow, these people are going to be coming here with their seconders to be nominated here. Honorable, thank you so much. And unfortunately, because of time, I cannot go ahead with you. But you know, we shall be keeping tabs on this today and tomorrow as they get nominated. We know so many are getting nominated. This is Morning at NTV. Thank you so much for being a part of this. Stephen Mbidi on Fefe Swechibuga, taking back to studio because I know Romeo Busiku is there and is going to give you birthday showers and much more information.
Well, thank you very much, Stephen Mbidi, reporting live from the